Your doctor tells you you've got a blocked artery and you need a stent stat. But do you really? We bring you the bottom line on the truth about stents. Hi, I'm Pilar Gerasimo with a bottom line expert report on clearing coronary blockages. I'm here with Dr. Suzanne Steinbaum. She is the Director of Women's Heart Health at Lenox Hill Hospital in New York. So Dr. Suzanne, I know that 600,000 stents were implanted last year, and I read a study that said that maybe as many as half of them were unnecessary or inappropriate. What's the deal? Are we just putting stents in people for fun?
In the situation of a heart attack, when a stent is put in, it could actually be a life-saving procedure. It reinstores blood flow to an area that wasn't getting any blood. In that situation, a stent is necessary. But for many people, those who have a heart attack, it happens when their blockages are 30 to 50%. Stents are put in at 70% or greater, and that's a Band-Aid. The real cure is in prevention through lifestyle choices, diet and exercise, and sometimes medication.
That's great, but can you talk a little bit more about the alternative approaches to dealing with it?
Sometimes stents are put in when someone has symptoms of chest pain or angina, and some other alternatives could be medication or exercise, or there might be other options that you can talk to your doctor about. But a stent is not a sure-all fix. Again, it's a Band-Aid, and it can help with symptoms. But sometimes medications might help just as well, if not more.
The bottom line on stents is that they're only a life-saving procedure in the case of 100% blockages. In lesser cases, they're more of a bandage. So you might want to talk to your doctor and investigate your options before submitting to this invasive procedure. For more advice on a healthier life, go to bottomlinehealth.com.